be forceful, but be also allow degrees of freedom to your teams to re-engineer themselves.
We're joined by Joe from Salesforce and Jean-Manuel from BCG. Welcome. Joe, you've described this moment as transcendental as far as AI and the customer experience is concerned, which is a remarkable description. Just explain what's changed. Why is this such a big moment for it?
Well, I think, you know, I use transcendental because I think it's a great word that really talks about the fact that the things that came before are just very different than where we are now. You know, expecting an agent to be able to understand people in, you know, all sorts of ways, nuances of language, indirect ways of asking a question, spelling errors, all that sort of stuff. You know, computers would have had a really hard time doing that 3 years ago. And now it just works, and they can, and they understand intent. They can, you know, fake or express empathy, you know, like however, whatever side of the line you get on. But that then you stack those capabilities and they drive real business outcomes. And so now you can really have a meaningful relationship with your customer, portraying your brand values in a way that just resonates, similar to talking to a human. And that's just something that we just never seen before in computer science. Always the promise. Now it's actually the delivery of that promise.
It's finally arrived.
It has.
Jean-Manuel, we've seen AI is transforming the customer experience, as we just said. It's a transcendental moment. How is that changing pricing strategy?
I think it's changing the way companies are going to get paid and extract value for the value they create. And you could see it already with AI. Right now, the main model of AI is you pay per person, right? So on OpenAI and on, you know. And so that means we are enhancing the role of a person, the value a person can add. Soon with agents, we're going to get the model of getting paid per task, with agents achieving something. And so these two models are going to, I think, run in parallels with corresponding to the two ways AI can add value to us, either by doing things or by making us better.
Yeah, which is remarkable. Why are some companies benefiting from AI and others not so much yet?
Well, you know, I think about AI as a tool, but you have to have the raw materials. And it really comes back down to the data. And I think what happens is if you look at where people have been, you know, there's a mechanization phase of the data. Can you actually get it collected and put it someplace? And then there's an automation phase. And then traditionally, I would have said machine learning phase, where you can actually then start take actions based upon real deep insights. And now we have sort of the agentic side. I'm not even sure you need three as much anymore. But if you haven't started with one, then you're going to have a real hard time getting to agents. Whereas if companies have curated, they have a data lake, they're already taking some actions, maybe some machine learning in there, they're already prepped. So at that point, all of those data sources just become sauce for the goose of the agent. But if you haven't started that journey, then you have to catch up.
Are you seeing this two-tier system now, effectively, with some companies speeding ahead?
That's right. And I think in addition to the data that Joe talked about, there is also a readiness that is needed about changing your entire processes and to reimagine what you are going to do. Usually, AI can't replace completely what humans do. They do some part of it much better, but they allow humans to focus on other things that are most of the time much more value added, much more interesting. But you need to allow the degrees of freedom for people to change their roles. So you need to look at the incentives, the organization structure, and to rethink that simultaneously. So companies that are natives and already start from scratch tend to invent the new processes right away. Companies that need to transform from an existing to the new need to really be deciding very forcefully to go this way. And if you're not very forceful, you might be stuck into the old ways for quite a while.
What's one piece of advice that you'd give to any company now on how they can get ahead using AI?
Well, the first advice is to be forceful, but be also allow degrees of freedom to your teams to re-engineer themselves. So if you leave everybody in very narrow roles and you ask yourself, can we replace that role or that other roles? Maybe none of the roles could be replaced completely, but you rethink through the entire value chain and the process that people were doing, and there's new roles that are going to emerge, and you need to think already through that.
Yeah, I totally agree. I think that's the way I look at it as well, but I also think it's a question of be really, really, really crisp on the what you want to get done and be very, very flexible on the how you get it done. And I think that's where some people confuse those two things. They confuse the what and the how because of people, because of jobs. And I think that does make it harder. But if you're really clear about the what and you're flexible about the how, you can get some amazing things accomplished very quickly.
Excellent advice. Well, thank you both for joining us here in Cannes.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you very much, Wendy.